I mean, off the court, you know, I look at myself like a gentle giant. I'm just a good person overall. Go out of my way for anybody. You know, I believe in treating people with respect, you know, and you get the same in return. But on the court, it's a little different. I like to express my emotions through the way I play and through good plays and slam dunks and great highlights.
And Reynolds says it's not going to happen for you, but he's got so much power on the edge of the paint.
Oh, and the putback from the league's leading offensive rebounder, Jalen Reynolds, with 5 points to begin this fourth quarter.
So off the court, I'm a totally different person. But on the court, you know, you got to show that grit and the hunger. I think it's a time and a place for everything. For me personally, just showing my emotion on the court and that anger, you know, I want to put fear into my opponent so he can feel me, you know, every play and every situation on the court. But off the court, I'm a good guy, you know. So I try to lead, and hopefully the guys will follow. Whether that's, you know, whether that's scoring or not scoring or just cheering on the bench, just trying to be the best teammate I can be to get that spark under the guys, because it's a long season, you know? So just, you know, there's going to be days and it's not into it, but I try to bring that energy, and hopefully they feed off of that. I was 14. My mom was like, "What are you doing to your body?" But personally, it's what I like to do. I think my body's my temple to express my art. You know what I like and what I love. Looking up to Brian, Dwight Howard, these type of athletes. Just always wanted to have one. And you know, once you get your first one, it's like, okay, all right, this is good. Everyone likes it, but it's really addictive, and you really can't stop getting them. Well, for me personally, I can't stop getting them. It's more of a therapeutic thing for me, for some reason. It takes me somewhere else. Like, if I see something or something that I'm just thinking about, I'll get it. Like, you know, something that's meaningful to me, I'll get it. And obviously, once you see that Detroit on my arm, you're like, oh, he's from Michigan. I'm not a Detroit bad boy, but the legacy lives on. You know, once you see that, you know, oh, okay, he's from Detroit. Just being a diehard fan of, you know, my city and how it used to be to where it's at now and how it's slowly coming back to be in a better place and a place where people want to be. Keep my city alive and expressing it through my ink and you know everything else that I do in life. It was almost a competition.
Again.
Yeah, in college, like all my teammates were getting them. So I'm like, now I got to get some more. Because I wanted to have the most tattoos. And then it went from a couple tattoos to sleeve and to sleeve to on my neck to on my legs and then to my face. I wanted this one to really stand out because I couldn't make it to see her passing due to basketball and being so far away. It was a hard time for me coping with that and not being there for my family. But she would have wanted me to stay and continue, you know, working hard and making her proud. That's my baby. It's my baby girl, man. She understands that I'm working hard for her to pretty much have the best life she can have. It's bittersweet. You know, being so far away sometimes, not having her up under me like I really would like to. But I'm working right now, and she'll understand it as she gets older. Maybe she'll fall into the footsteps of basketball or whatever her heart desires. But I just want her to know that I'm working hard for her to have the things that I didn't have. And not that I didn't have a lot, you know, my mom worked really hard, and she made sure we had everything we pretty much wanted. Shout out to my mom. But yeah, it's my daughter. That's my world. Like this is like they asked me like someone asked me like why do you work so hard? Like cause my daughter got to eat. My family got to eat. So for me, I just want to be the best I can be. Literally the best big I can be. Whether that's EuroLeague or wherever I'm at, I want to be the best I can be. And when I step on that court, I want you to know. I want you to feel me. And now he'll free.
They closed out on him hard because they know he's a great three-point shooter, and that left Reynolds alone on the box.
The college that I went to, it was a really great school, Xavier University. Shout out to Xavier. Their development for players is through the roof. Having Coach Mack there and Coach Steele, two of my favorite guys, they just know how to develop this particular athlete, this athlete, or that athlete. And for me, being a big man, they knew exactly what I needed to do and where I needed to be as far as strength, mental and physical. I would probably say I was probably the strongest I've ever been in college. We were literally lifting every day. Like I was like addicted to lifting weights and developing my game. And like the gym is always open for us. So it was just like, it could be a Friday night. Everybody's out partying. We'll be in the gym having pickup. Yeah, or the tattoo studio, Well, we later on got a coach, Coach Pagese, which was a former athlete, not at Xavier. I would just say just his techniques as far as, you know, being dominant in the paint and just being the best I can be, whether that's, but his main thing was working on my left hand because I never would like to use my left hand. Still to this day, I do, so don't. But most importantly, just developing my hands and my feet work and, being, because you know, tall, it's harder to move, like how guards move. But he wanted the bigs to be able to move just like guards and defend at a very high level. So I would say that moment was very pivotal for me in college, developing my game to where it's at today. Basically, I took that to the heart because, you know, you work so hard to get to where you're at. And, you know, you got a lot of friends in the beginning. But when things, you know, get a little too far or you can't come back to the friend that you used to have every day and all the time, people think that you changed. But really, you're just getting better. And not necessarily that you're not, like you're forgetting about your friends. It's just, you know, it's a different chapter in your life and you can't be around everybody. So people think you change and then maybe they start talking about you. But at the end of the day, I still got love for you, but I just gotta love you from a distance. These two on the bottom of my ankles. It's the laugh now and cry later face. Because maybe for me, these mean a lot. Because it's like, all right, maybe you feel like you got one up on me, but at the end of the day, I'm gonna get the last laugh. Got Jesus Christ right here. Keep my faith with God, and then I got a bear over here. To keep that anger, that hunger in any situation that I'm in. That's basically what it is. It's my good and my bad side. Mm-hmm. So yeah. But many more to come.
Click here to subscribe to our channel and click here to watch our next video.